Hello, hi, good morning, guys.
Good morning, sir.
Morning. Okay, I'm having a little bit of trouble logging
in. Good morning, sir.
Good morning. Logging in from my computer. I've just logged in from my phone for the time being. And once I log in from my computer, then we can start. It's easier for me to annotate on my computer. Just give me 2 minutes. And what topic do you need to do? Any topic that you'd like me to do today, guys? Anything that you feel might be a bit tricky? Quadratic equations, anybody?
So could we do the quadratic equations based on problems?
Word problems? Yeah, we can do that. Just give me a few seconds. Okay, you guys can hear me now, right? I think I've logged in from my computer.
Yes, sir.
All right, so quadratic word problems it is. So the other parts of quadratic are okay, right? There are three other aspects to quadratic equations before we reach the word problems. And that's nature of roots. Just a check and see if you guys are okay with this. There's nature of roots, right? So nature of roots is a way to check what kind of solutions will a quadratic have, an x squared plus 5x plus 6 equals 0, if the quadratic's of that type. How do you check what the roots will be like? So there are three types of roots that you can have, and either the roots can be distinct, okay, and or they can be equal, or they can be imaginary. Just three things to remember in this. They're distinct, which means there are two roots, right? Two separate roots. Equal is there's only one root, or both the roots will be equal to one. And it's imaginary, which means there's practically no root, no solution for this. And how do you know that? It's distinct if the discriminant is greater than zero. It's equal if the discriminant is equal to zero, and it's imaginary if the discriminant is less than zero. What is the discriminant here? Discriminant is b squared minus 4ac. And how do you get b squared minus 4ac? So your quadratic is of the general form ax squared plus bx plus c equal to zero. Just write the quadratic that you have on hand along with the coefficients. So you have your x squared plus 5x plus 6 equals 0, which means in this that a is equal to 1, b is equal to 5, c is equal to 6. A is the coefficient of x squared, b is the coefficient of x, and c is the constant term. So put these values into this, find the discriminant, check the value of the discriminant, if it's positive, if it's zero, or if it's negative. Okay, and then you can decide what your roots will be. Distinct, it's two separate individual roots, or equal if it's one root, imaginary if it's no roots. Okay. So other than that, you have solving quadratic equation by factorizing by formula, okay, and then you'll get equations which are not written as ax squared plus bx plus c equal to zero. So you have to make them, okay, you have to make them in this form. They'll be given as some fraction or something like that, x minus 3 by x plus 3 plus, and so on. Okay, x plus 3 by x minus 3 is equal to 2.5, something like that. And then you have to make that, turn that into a quadratic. You guys are okay with this? If not, just a checklist, you can ask me. All right. So here goes. Word problems is, there are many types of word problems, okay? And I'll just pick up some selective ones. I'll try and pick up the ones that have come for the board in previous years, okay? So those are the ones that are most important. And if anyone has any other problems they want to suggest, go ahead and do this. Okay. Anybody has any problems that they want to suggest?
Not really, sir.
Sorry, say that again. Not Mariam, Debangi,
not really.
Naren, nothing?
No, sir.
Okay, you guys are really good, I must say then. Well prepared, good to see. Okay, let's just try and get a problem from quadratic. Problems, okay. Let me see if I can get a board problem. Give me a minute or so. I think there's one that says a car covers a distance of 400 kilometers at a certain speed. So this is speed distance time type. And yeah, we'll have a look at that. I'll put that problem up and then we can. I'll probably just write it out. A car covers a distance of 400 kilometers at a certain speed. At a certain speed. Had the speed been 12 kilometers per hour more, had the speed been 12 kilometers per hour more, the time taken for the journey would have been one hour 40 minutes less. Find the original speed of the car. And the original speed of the car. Just check and see if I've written it right. A car covers a distance of 400 kilometers at a certain speed. Had the speed been 12 kilometers per hour more, the time taken for the journey would have been 1 hour 40 minutes less. Find the original speed of the car. Okay. So there are two things to compare here. The old original speed and the new speed. Okay, and remember this is speed distance time problem. So the formula that you have to keep in mind is speed is equal to distance over time and all its inversions. Time is equal to distance by speed and distance is equal to speed into time. Find out what's given. Speed, distance, time among the three things, and then we can proceed. We'll just make some space here for our working. Hang on, let me just write this. So this is original speed, distance, and time. It's good to make these sort of columns and new. Okay, so what's given to us is a car covers a distance of 400 kilometers at a certain speed. We don't know what that speed is. So we'll write that as X, the original speed. Distance covered is 400. And just make sure the units are the same, all right? 400 kilometers. Usually with time, sometimes they give it in minutes. You'll have to convert that to hours because the unit for speed that we most often use is kilometers per hour in these kind of problems. Time is 1 hour 40. Time is not given here. And the new speed, had the speed been 12 kilometers per hour more, that means the old speed was X and this is X plus 12. And the distance is the same, 400 kilometers. The time taken for the journey would have been 1 hour 40 minutes less. Okay, so from here itself, we can get an expression for time. Okay, remember there's a formula here, time is equal to distance divided by speed. So time over here is 400 over X. And time here is 400 over X plus 12. Right? So it says that the time for the new journey or the faster journey would have been 1 hour 40 minutes less. So the difference between the two times is 1 hour 40 minutes, right? Okay, so the more time is taken here. So this is the bigger number, correct? More time is taken here. This is the faster journey, right? The new is the faster journey. That's why the slower journey would take more time. The reason I'm saying this is because you'll know that you have to put this term first, okay? Because this time time for the original journey minus the time for the new journey will be equal to 1 hour 40 minutes. Okay, that's 1 2/3 if you put that as a fraction. You guys okay with that? 1 hour 40 minutes is 1 2/3. So the difference between the two times is 1 hour 2/3. 1 2/3 hours. Anybody, any doubt? You want me to explain this again?
No, sir.
Good for this. So the original time was 400 over x minus new time is 400 over x plus 12. And this is, we'll make that mixed fraction into improper, 5 over 3. Taking the LCM, x and x plus 12 is x times x plus 12. And when you get an algebraic expression, what you should be doing with the numerators is this times this. So 400 in, and then this times this, okay? So that's 400 into x plus 12 minus 400x. Okay, that's what I just did here. 400 into x plus 12 and 400x. Okay. You're okay with this? Want me to explain that again? Fine, right? Let me know if anybody wants me to explain that again. It's just...
No, sir, it's fine.
Simple algebra. Okay. Now, from now on, it's just simplification. So expanding the numerator here, 400x plus 4800 minus 400x is equal to 5 by 3. And there's a denominator here, which is x squared plus 12x. The 400x and the 400x cancels. So, and then you cross multiply. So you get 4,800 into 3, which is 24,14400 is equal to 5x squared plus 60x. Okay, because this term goes up here, gets multiplied by the 5, and you get this. Okay, so your expression, your equation is now 5x squared plus 60x minus 14400 is equal to 0. So you've got a quadratic, and we can solve this. I'm just going to continue it here. So we see that this entire quadratic is divisible by 5. All the three terms, that quadratic. So you can divide it by 5 to simplify it. Whenever you get an opportunity, it's always better to. It makes the job easier. Of course, you can continue with this, but it's better to reduce it to its lowest term. Okay. So dividing all terms by 5, 5x squared becomes just x squared. 60x becomes 12x minus 14400 becomes half, right? So it will be 14400. Just a moment. Five. It's 2880. Okay. So now we've got to find two numbers. I think you know how to solve this by factorization, right? Find two numbers whose sum or difference is 12. Sum or difference is 12. And whose product is minus 2880. Minus 2880. So what could those numbers be? What could those two numbers be? Guys, anybody? Yeah. So a good way to do this is try and find the factors of 2880. Okay, what numbers could factorize these? Okay. Anybody? Guys, I thought you were good at this. Anybody find the factors of these? No? Yeah? Aniriya, Naren, Mariam, Debangi. Come on, guys.
So what happens is in the exam, this takes so much time. I don't know any other way to solve it.
Is it? Okay. Okay. So, generally a good way is to prime factorize this 2880. Okay. Find factors. And see, since the difference is 12, it's not a very big difference. What you could do is just approximately find the square root of this ish. Okay. So 288. Okay. Not even square root. Try out two numbers which look very, very simple. So 2880 could be. Let's say, okay, square root it. Approximately, what would the square root be? Ish. Not even exact value. Okay, 50 squared, you know, is 2,500, right? So this would be, if you did, so the numbers would be close to 50-ish, somewhere there and thereabouts. Okay, that's usually what I do. I try and find, because 50 would tell you kind of like a midpoint, two equal, factors it would give you. And then the separation is just 12. So it'll be something a little over 50. 53, 54 would be the, somewhere around about that, 50 and 60, somewhere around about that. Okay. So just looking at that, it should be 60 in, or just divided by 60, let's say, 288. 2880 divided by 60, what would that give you? 4s are 24, 6 8s are. So 60 and 48 seem like a good fit because they are separated by 12. The difference is 12 and 60 and minus 48. And if you multiply them, you would get 2880. Yeah. So x squared plus 60x minus 48x minus 2880 equals 0. So what I do, why I take the square root here is because I know that if it's 50 squared is just a little less than that, then I know 54 and 54, if I multiply, then I'd get very close to that. Then I say, okay, since the difference is 12, I reduce 6 from that. You know, so 54 take away 6 or something. So 60 and 48 is what I got. But this is a bit of a guessing game. And the thing is, you'll have to try and work out, you know, the sort of easiest way that you can guess this. Prime factorization is one of the methods if it's a smaller number. But, and remember, usually this is, don't try the formula route, okay, for these. If anyone's tempted to use the quadratic formula, I would suggest against it because the numbers will be massive, okay, for you to work with. I mean, it'll take you at least 5 minutes with some of these, all right? guys okay with that? I think best thing is to try out a few factors here and there. Prime factorize it or take the square root and find the numbers that might be close to it. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So if you find the square root and you realize that B is, that's the middle term, is about 30, find the square root and look for numbers that are 15 less and 15 more, if the difference is 30, okay? If the difference is 10, find the square root of that and look for numbers that are 5 more or 5 less, okay? So that could be one of the methods that you can use to estimate. Okay, now on, it's not too difficult here. So x into x plus 60 minus 48 into x plus 60, just factorizing this. So x plus 60 is equal to 0, which means x is negative 60, which doesn't work. Or x minus 48 is 0, which means x is 48. I think a positive value for speed would be a better option. Negative values, speed can't really be negative in this case. So we'll take the positive value. That's 48 should be your answer here. Okay with that, guys? So let me know.
So could you please repeat that?
Yeah, the last part?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let me just enlarge the screen, make it full screen. Okay. Hopefully you can see it better now. Yeah, the quadratic factorization from here onwards. So I've written that as, I found the two factors, 60 and minus 48. Okay, because 60 and minus 48, if I add them, I get 12, which is my B term. And if I multiply 60 into 48, I get 2880. Why? Because I've just divided this by 60 and I've got 48. So I found my factors. That's plus 60 and minus 48. All right. And then I did x into x plus 60 minus 48 into x plus 60 is equal to 0. Okay with that? Basically just took out the common terms. And then x plus 60 and x minus 48 is equal to 0. So I got x is minus 60 and x is 48. Minus 60 is not a value that I can use. Speed can't be negative. So I stay with my x equals 48. Okay. So in these word problems, generally it's a three-step process. First step is declare the variable. So in this case, it was let x be the original speed of the car. That was your variable. Second is find the equation or find the quadratic. This is the part that most of the students have difficulty with, finding the quadratic. Okay, but you can use your formula. You can use the, in this case, speed, distance, time formula and apply it there. You can get your quadratic. And third, of course, is solve the quadratic, which should be okay-ish. Only finding the factors, as you said, might take a bit of time. Okay. So is that okay, guys? Fine with that? No? Still tough? Okay. It should get easier as we move on. Let me see if I can pick up another one. We'll try a different type. Okay, speed, distance, time is okay. We'll try a different type. You can hear me reasonably well, right? So anybody want
yes,
to make?
Yes, sir.
Trying to take on sums that are most likely sort of going to come. Speed, distance, cost, all those things are very, very likely to come. Yeah, there's one over here, and I'll show you what that is. This is okay. You guys are fine with this?
Yes, sir.
There's one more type, and I'll show you what that is. This had come for an exam before. Okay. Let me switch the screen. Okay, it says a trader buys X articles for a total cost of 600. Write down the cost of one article in terms of X. Anybody? The first part just says write down the cost of one article in terms of X. So if he buys X articles for a cost of 600, 10 apples, for 600 rupees, guys, what's the cost of one apple? 10 apples costing 600 rupees, what's the cost of one apple?
Yeah.
Guys, anybody? Second standard sum. Hello, people. Yeah? So, a trader buys X articles for a cost of 600. Okay, so 10 articles cost 600. One article will cost 600 by X, right? So one apple's cost is 600 by 10. The same formula you apply here. So this will be 600.
So is that 600 or 660?
100.
Sorry.
600 by X. Okay, so that's the cost of one article. Okay, so this had come in 1999. It's a long time back, but it has come before, right? This is an actual exam sum. Okay, if the cost per article were 5 rupees more, the number of articles that can be bought for 600 would be 4 less. Okay, write down the equation in X for the above situation and solve it for X, which is pretty much what the, what you'll have to do with most quadratic problems, word problems. Okay, so again, that table form, I feel makes it a lot easier to understand. Okay, so the cost is, let's say the cost is X. All right. The cost is, if the cost per article is X, okay, and number of articles X is already written there, my bad. X is a variable is used. Okay. So the number of articles that can be bought, okay, this is cost of one, okay, and total price. So these are the three things that are involved in this: the cost of one article, the number of articles, and the total price. So it's for 600 rupees is the price, the number of articles that can be bought are X, and the cost of one therefore is 600 over X. So if the cost of the article was 5 rupees more, okay? So in case the cost of one article was 5 rupees more, so it's already 600 by X. If I added 5 rupees to this, the number of articles would be 4 less. So now I could buy X articles. Now I can only buy X minus 4 articles. And the price again is 600. Okay, is that fine? Yeah. So you know that in your mind, cost of one article, that's what we call as unit price into number of articles is the total cost, right? So if you're buying an apple costs you 10 rupees, let's say, and you're buying five apples. So the cost of one apple is 10 into number of apples, five will give you the total price, your total shopping amount. Okay. So just, so that formula is important. That's the formula you've got to use here. Okay. Unit price into quantity gives you the total price. All right, guys.
Yes.
Okay. So what's the equation you'll form and how will you form the equation here? Anybody? Use the formula here. See if you can do this in your notebooks. Okay, unit price is the same thing over here. Basically, this into this will give you this. Okay, this into this will give you this. You don't even need to write it again. So in these equations, what you can see is that this into this gives you 600. This into this also gives you 600, which means these two should be equal, correct?
Yes, sir.
So 600 over X into X is equal to 600 by X plus 5 brackets into X minus 4. This cancels, of course. Is that okay? So just sort of simplify this. The right-hand side will be X 600 plus 5X into X minus 4 is equal to 600. Since this is common denominator, we can move this here. So 600x is equal to, on the right-hand side, we can just multiply it. 600 plus 5x into x minus 4 is equal to 600x. Multiply this by this. 600 into minus 4 is minus 2,400 plus 5x squared. Minus 20x. Just simplify this into a quadratic. We get 5x squared. 600x and minus 20x is minus 580x. And then 2400. Oh, there's just a minute. I think one more term was on the left-hand side. We can use that to simplify as well. I'm so sorry. But we can cancel those two terms, right? The 600x here and the 600x here can be canceled. You're following this, right? Anybody not following this? Just simplifying it using algebra. So I divide this entire thing by 5 because all the terms are divisible by 5. And I get x squared minus 4x. Minus 480, I think, is equal to zero. So that's your quadratic. And you can solve this, find the factors. So see if you can find the factors. We can work out the factors. Anybody? So in my mind, I'm just thinking of this term here to factorize it. And I'm thinking square root of a number close by. 400 square root is 20, right? And the difference between them is 4. So of course, 480 is a bit more than this thing. So it will be 2 this side and 2 this side. It could be 18 and 20 or something like that in that vicinity. Okay. Or maybe just a few numbers here and there. So if I do 18 into 20, it's 360 only. I need to find bigger numbers. Maybe 20 and 24 or something like that. Right? And what does that give you? Actually, it is 20 and 24. You need minus 4x, so 20 and minus 24, right? Because minus 480. So I get, and just continue it here. So it's x squared plus 20x minus 24x minus 480 equals 0. So x into x plus 20 minus 24 into x plus 20 equals 0. So x minus 24 equals 0 or x plus 20 equals 0, which means here x is 24. That's one value. And here it means x is minus 20 because x plus 20 equals 0. So we can cancel this out. This is the number of articles, can't be negative. So I think x would be 24. Answer is 24 articles. Is that fine, guys? Any part of this that you didn't understand, you want me to repeat?
No, sir.
Anyone else? Debangi, Mariam, Anaria?
No, sir.
Like I said, just keep practicing the topics that we're doing, the same topic. You can even practice. I mean, you can do that for two days of practice of this, or 2-3 days, because there are lots of sums, will be fine. And try to keep the rate of at least 10 sums per day going in math. That's about an hour's practice. So every day an hour's practice for math should be good. All right. You're about a month away from the exams, a month and maybe a week or 10 days away from the exams. Okay, so every day 10 sums, 40 days, you do more than 400 sums, or 400, 500 sums. Okay, so keep the regular practice going and you really do well. Okay. Can I erase this and put up another sum? The next sum that I'm going to do is an important one, because I think it's come, if I'm not mistaken, twice in the, at least once I know, maybe twice in the boards. If anybody is not following any step, just don't hesitate to ask me at all. Like I said, this is for you guys, not so much for me to solve, but for you to understand. And if you have any sums that you might find difficult, let me know. Okay, here it is. You might recognize this sum. Okay. If you've done past papers and things like that, this is... Okay, so just reading out the sum. In an auditorium, seats were arranged in rows and columns. The number of rows was equal to the number of seats in each row. So just sort of mentally visualizing an auditorium, which something like this. So it says in an auditorium, seats were arranged in rows and columns. The number of rows was equal to the number of seats in each row. So if there were 1, 2, 3, 4 rows, the number of seats in each row was also equal, which means it was a square arrangement, right? Which means it was a square arrangement. So if the number of rows were doubled, if the number of rows was doubled and the number of seats in each row was reduced by 10. So number of rows were doubled and the number of seats in each row were increased by 10. Reduced by 10, sorry. So they are doubling the number of rows. So this is becoming double. And this is being reduced by some amount. Oopsie. Something like this. Just sort of visualizing this. Okay, they've reduced the number of seats. So here initially, the number of rows was X, let's say, and the number of columns, that's the number of seats in each row, would also be X. Okay, in the second case, the number of rows was doubled, so it would be 2X, and the number of seats in each row was reduced by 10. So instead of X, it would be X minus 10. Okay, got this? And then, so to calculate the total number of seats, because it says the total number of seats changed, right? Increased by 300. So what would be the number of seats in the first arrangement? Number of seats in the first arrangement would be X into X, right? X squared would be the number of seats. And here, the number of seats would be X minus 10 into 2X, which would be 2X squared minus 20X. Okay. Which would be total number of seats here would be this. Is that okay, guys? Basically, this is the area, number of seats. So it says the difference. So the number of seats are this and this. Okay, in this, the number of seats would be less by 300. Oh, I'm sorry, increase by more by 300. What am I doing? Would be more by 300. So this is the bigger quantity, right? So the number of seats after, we'll just call that as capital N, minus the number of seats beforehand, small n, would be 300. You agree with that? So the number of seats in the new arrangement minus the number of seats in the old arrangement would be 300, right? Because in the new arrangement, it's 300 more. Okay, so what's the number of seats in the new arrangement? It's 2x squared. Minus 20x, right? This is the number of seats in the new arrangement. So we'll write that down as 2x squared minus 20x. Minus seats in the old arrangement was x squared. Minus x squared is equal to 300. Okay. So it's 2x squared minus 20x minus x squared is equal to 300. Just simplifying this to give us a quadratic, x squared minus 20x minus 300 is equal to 0. Okay. Now that we've got our quadratic, we can try to find the terms, find the factors rather. Okay, so it's, again, I'm trying to use my method of finding factors and things like that. So this is good enough to factorize, a small enough number to factorize. So 300, if I were to factorize and try and find numbers that would give me a sum or difference of minus 20. Okay, so what could the numbers be? What two numbers multiply to give you 300? 15 into 20 would give you 300, right? What else? 30 into 10 would give you 300. Actually, that seems to be a pretty good choice because the difference between these is 20 as well. So if I take 30 and minus 10, if I add them, I mean, minus 30 and plus 10 rather, I'd add them, I'd get minus 20, and if I multiply them, I get minus 300, which is what I want, right? So it's minus 30 and plus 10. So it's x squared minus 30x plus 10x minus 300 equals 0. So it's x into x minus 30 plus 10 into x minus 30 is equal to 0. So it's x plus 10 equals 0, which implies that x is minus 10, or x minus 30 is equal to 0, which implies x is 30. So I don't take the negative value. I take the positive value. X is 30. So x is the number of rows in the original arrangement. So that's my answer to part one. Part one's answer is 30 rows. And the beauty of this kind of sums is you can, once you have your answer, you can even check and see. So if I were to 30 rows and 30 seats per row, this would be 30 into 30 is 900 seats in the first arrangement. And if I increase, if I double the number of rows, that's 30 into 2 is 60. And 30 minus 10, 20, 60 into 20 is 1,200. So it is indeed 300 seats more, right? Earlier it was 900, now it's 1,200. So I can check my answer as well. Okay. All right. So, and the second part is the number of seats in the auditorium after rearrangement. And that's 1,200. We've just solved that. Answer is 1,200 seats. Is that okay, guys? Everybody understood? Any doubts, anything at all? Like I said, it's a popular sum. Just got to be careful. Yep, guys, okay with this? Can we move on? Anybody has any questions? You can ask me, okay? Okay, just moving forward. There's time and work sums. Should we do a time and work sum? Guys, we try out this time and work sum, okay? Usually this is a pretty tricky one for most. Okay. Can you hear me? Everybody can hear me? Hello? Anybody can hear me? All right, so Mohan takes 16 days less than Manoj to do a piece of work. If both working together can do it in 15 days, in how many days will Mohan alone complete the work? Okay, so this is, First, in these kind of problems, the first thing you need to do is find the rate of work. That means how much work they can do in one day, right? Okay, so let's consider, let's say the number of days that Mohan takes to do the work can be X, all right? So remember in these sums, the first step is always declaring the variable. So here we are declaring the variable. So let number of days Mohan takes is equal to X. Therefore, Mohan's rate of work, that means how much he can do in one day, is 1 over X, right? How did I work that out? If, you know, for instance, Ram takes 6 days to paint a house, that means in one day, a rate of Ram's work would be 1/6, right? All right, so in one day, 1/6 of the work. If he takes 6 days to do the entire work, so every day, 1/6, 1/6, 1/6, in 6 days, the job gets done. So you invert the number of days to get the rate of work. It's in one day. Mohan's rate is 1/X. Okay. And Manoj takes 16 days more, right? So number of days for Manoj is equal to X plus 16, right? Therefore, Manoj's rate is equal to 1/X+16. So in one day, if both were to work, that means Mohan's one day work and Manoj's one day work, if you were to add, that means it would be the combined one day work, right? In one day, how much work they can both do together. So both in one day would be doing 1/X+1/X+16. Okay. So in one day, this much is what they'll be doing. Is that okay so far, guys? Any doubts? No? Okay. So if both are working together, they could finish it in 15 days. So in one day, both would do 1/15 of the work. Okay. So simplifying this equation should give you the value of X. That's the number of days that Mohan takes, all right? So the LCM is X times X plus 16. That's X plus 16 plus X on the numerator is equal to 1/15. So X plus X gives you 2X plus 16, cross multiply into 15. I'm bringing the 15 in from here, is equal to this. So it's X squared plus 16X. So simplifying, 30X plus 16 into 15 is 240 is equal to X squared plus 16X. Just simplifying all of this stuff, X squared plus 16 minus 30 is minus 14X. Minus 240 is equal to zero, right? All right, so here goes. So simplifying this basically involves finding factors. And 240, anybody? Minus 240, what two numbers would multiply to give you this? So 20 into 12 would give you this, right? 240 But 20 and 12 don't really give you 14. So we need to find some other set of numbers. What do you think we can do? Which other numbers would go in this? Anyone? So what's the best thing? You can do 10 into 24 as well, right? That'll give you minus 240. I mean, one of them has to be minus. Since it's minus 14, the bigger number should be minus. This works, right? Minus 24 and 10. Okay, so it's x squared minus 24x plus 10x minus 240 equals 0. X into x minus 24. From here on, it's just basic simplification. So x can be either x minus 24 is 0, which implies that x is 24, or x plus 10 equals 0, which means x is minus 10, which we don't need to consider. So x is equal to 24. So the answer is 24 days. Do you want me to re-explain it? You guys got it? You want, you can take a screenshot or copy the page down or something. Done, guys. You wrote it down. Anyone still writing or taking a screenshot?
So 1 minute, sir. I'm still writing.
Yeah, yeah. Let me know when you're done, everybody.
Done, sir.
Everybody? Anybody still writing? Okay, so just a quick check with you guys, since I am concerned about how you guys are going to do in the boards. Do you study math every day or every alternate day? Just a quick check, everybody. Debangi, you study math? Do you... the alternate days, how do you guys prep? Do you guys have a schedule? You know, you're going to do this chapter today, that chapter another day. If you don't, then I encourage you to have a schedule, so you'll be able to keep a track of what you've done and what's left. All right, and try and finish everything by the end of by about 20th of April. Just finish all your revision and start taking mocks periodically. Whenever you finish, if you've already finished, you can start taking the mock tests and so on and so forth. All right. And if you want to exchange any mock test papers with me, any pre-board papers, let me know. I have some, I can give it to you. And if you have any, you can share them with me as well, so we can pass it around. All right. You can message me, WhatsApp me or something if you need any mock papers. All right. Pre-board papers, because it's difficult to get pre-board papers this year. I understand with a lot of changing in the syllabus, the older papers are not really, I mean, there's a lot of change from the older papers. So the pre-board papers will be very helpful. So I think I have one or two of them and I can pass it on to you. And if you have any, you can share the same with me. So I guess everybody will have access to all of them. Okay, so make sure that you guys do 10 sums every day. Keep that rate going. It's just an hour. If you can do more, great, but at least that much. Okay, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. We can either continue this topic, whatever doubts you have, or we can pick another topic. All right. So I'll see you guys. And like I said, you have my number and email. Anytime you have any doubts, just don't hesitate to sting me. And spread the word. We don't mind having more students coming in as well. Okay. So you guys have a great Saturday. I think tomorrow our class is on as well. Okay. Bye, guys. See you all. Have a good Saturday.
Thank you, sir. Have a nice day.
Yeah, you too. Bye.